In this series of tutorials, I will discuss methods for extracting models from major video games, for educational and transformative purposes, of course. In this episode, I'll show you how to unpack files from one of the most common game engines on the market, the Unreal Engine by Epic Games. The Unreal Engine has been used to create over 300 major video games and powers some of the most iconic properties of the past two decades, including Fortnite, Mass Effect, Gears of War, and the Dirty Gyno Doctor's fertilization clinic not safe for work. Before we get to unpack Unreal Engine models, make sure to subscribe to the channel for future videos about grabbing models and textures from other game engines. The main tool we'll be using to unpack Unreal Engine models is a tool called UE Viewer, aka UModel. This tool allows you to view and unpack static meshes, skeletal meshes, animations, and textures from the majority of Unreal Engine games. While UE Viewer may work with Fortnite, we'll use a special tool to unpack Fortnite content. We'll discuss this in a future video. Subscribe to be notified as soon as this video is released. UE Viewer is the work of Gildor, a game engine software developer from St. Petersburg, Russia. He has spent much of his spare time reverse engineering and maintaining the tools many of us use to unpack Unreal Engine assets. If you use and appreciate his work and want him to keep updating it, make sure you send him a generous donation on his website. So let's take a look at UE Viewer more closely. It has support for many games, but definitely not all of them, and there are some limitations for the games it does support. This is why we look at the UE Viewer compatibility table. It provides a list of Unreal Engine games that UE Viewer has been tested with. The leftmost columns indicate year and game title. The rightmost columns are the game engine version and the name of the developer. The remaining four columns in the middle indicate which components the UE Viewer can unpack. For example, most games listed support the extraction of skeletal meshes, skel, textures, text, animation, anim, and static meshes, stat. However, some games like the Final Fantasy VII Remake don't support the extraction of skeletal meshes and animations. This could be because the developer, Square Enix, has made adjustments to the way the animation system works in their version of the engine. In some cases, it may be that the compatibility table is out of date. For example, UE Viewer supports a specific version of Fortnite, but Epic Games might release a new update that breaks compatibility. Keep an eye on Gildor's Twitter account and message board for future updates. But also, don't pester him to update your particular game. Remember, he's maintaining this program for free in his spare time. You don't get to make demands about how he spends his time. Now let's pick our game. Personally, I'm a big fan of science fiction. I especially love Mass Effect for its realistic and relatable characters. I especially like Edie, and would definitely like to have a sexy pet robot myself. You can pick any other Unreal Engine game you already own. The structure is often similar. Make sure it is on the compatibility list with support for all the assets you would like to grab. Download it and let it install. I downloaded Mass Effect 3 through Origin. Meanwhile, we can also download UE Viewer. Since most of you will be using Windows, that's the version we'll use in this tutorial. But if you are a super chad like me, there is a Linux version for the command line as well. Whatever version you choose, they all unpack the same games, meaning Linux version will be able to extract files for games that were made for Windows or consoles. Scroll down on the UE Viewer page and hit download for the Win32 version. It's just a zip file with an executable, no fancy installers or anything. Running umodel.exe should open up the UI. Set the path to be the folder where your game is located. You probably set this while installing the game, and can probably find it in your Epic Launcher or Steam itself. Below, there are two sections with view/export object types and export only types. The view and export types are ones that can be previewed in the UE Viewer. The export-only types cannot be previewed and must be extracted directly to files. We will leave all the view and export object types checked for now, but you can uncheck them if your game of choice does not support them. You can optionally enable sound export. Scale form and face effects are old file types for Unreal Engine 3 and can be unchecked if you don't know what they are. You can leave the package compression and platform settings on auto. Let's hit OK and the UE viewer will start looking around in the game directory for game packages. When the developers package the final game assets, this is referred to as cooking. The cooked files are grouped into directories for a specific platform. For PC games, this means that the assets will usually end up in the cooked PC or cooked PC console folder. This is where we'll find the assets we're looking for. Knowing something about game development helps decipher the project structure. For example, a game has many maps. Some levels will have models that are exclusive to that map. But some models, like characters and weapons, will be shared between levels. Because games are so big and memory is still limited, we don't duplicate every model in the map archive, and we don't load all the game assets into memory at once. To organize the project and ensure we're saving resources, we put common elements into shared packages and assets that are of single use into the map archive we actually use them in. This structure will of course vary depending on the game. Every game studio has a different package structure and naming conventions. This sometimes makes it difficult to find certain models. Sometimes this is further complicated by DLC packages and add-ons. It can take some time and a bit of looking and trying before you find what you need. So let's dig in and find the ED model. I'm gonna step into the cooked PC folder and sort by size. This way, we can quickly eliminate packages that don't contain a lot of assets. Now let's filter for ED. We see a bunch of package names that contain a lot of abbreviations. I know from experience that for Mass Effect 3, levels are prefixed with the abbreviation BIO-D, and hero characters often with BIO-H. So BIO-H underscore ED underscore 00 looks promising. Let's open it up. We can use the page up and page down keys to step through each file in the archive. We're mostly seeing effects textures at first. Lots of textures and meshes used for the biotics and tech abilities. Let's keep going. Aha, there's a familiar texture. And there's the mesh, old textures and everything. This is the package we want to export. We could export single objects, but it'll be easier to export everything in the file. Hit O to go back to the package overview and make sure the package is selected. Hit Export. Set the export path to be where you have ample disk space. For mesh export, we could choose ActorX, but I prefer GLTF 2.0 since it's supported in Blender without an additional add-on. TGA is a good texture format to export, so we'll leave that as default. Hit OK and check the output window for progress and errors. We'll find the GLTF files in the skeletal mesh 3 directory, and the textures will be in the texture 2D directory. Import the relevant GLTF files into Blender and set up the materials using the textures in the folders. And there you have it, our own pet robot. It's got all the armature controls on there as well. From here, we can do whatever we want with these models and textures. We can render images, animations, or export them to other programs like Source Filmmaker. And that concludes this tutorial. Subscribe to the channel so you'll be notified when we use a different program to extract models from Fortnite. We will also get into extracting models from other games and games engines in the future. Thank you for watching.